Everything has beauty in it, but not everyone sees it. Today, we are going to look into the poem, A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. Investigate the things that can cause pain and suffering in human life. What makes human beings love life in spite of sufferings and troubles? Learning objective: examine and analyze the pleasure a beautiful thing can give us. Here are three pictures. Analyze the picture and state why it is beautiful. Let's listen.
A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health and quiet breathing. Therefore, on every morrow we are writing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Spite of despondence, of the inhuman dread, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and o'er-darkened ways, made for our searching, yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. Such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon. For simple sheep, and such are daffodils, with the green world they live in, and clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make, gaze the hot season, the mid forest break, rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms. And such too is the grandeur of the dooms we have imagined for the mighty dead, all lovely tales that we have heard or read, an endless fountain of immortal drink pouring unto us from the heavenly brink.
Did you listen to it? Then prove. What do you think is the big picture of the poem, The Thing of Beauty? Now group 1, analyze the poem and infer its meaning. Group 2, justify the statement that man needs to be inclined with nature. Group 3, compose a poem with the same theme. Now we go on to the jam session, where you will be putting out the conclusions and examinations of the analysis. Justify your opinion on the poet's intention in focusing on a local issue and comment on an issue of global importance. Our next learning objective is infer, predict, and write down the poetic techniques used in relevance in the poem. infer the poetic devices used in the poem and plan a storyboard with similar techniques. John Keats was a romantic poet. He had written many poems. Now bring out few of the techniques that he has constantly used in writing his poems. It's quiz time. Here is your expansion task. Gather information on popular mythology. Prepare a storyboard on popular mythology. And group 3 will be preparing a script for a play of popular mythology.
For watching this channel for the first time, subscribe. If you like the content, click the like button and share. If you want to watch more of these videos, enable the bell icon. Thank you.